Your pricing represents the value that you offer. And the value is made up of scope, which is then further split down into complexity and preference. So every client is different, right? We are never going to, because we're not a commodity, we cannot say that the old model of, yeah, we own a 30% markup on our costs. That's an old model that is archaic. It doesn't kind of, it has no relevance to client output. So the way you need to look at it is that every client will generate a different return on investment for you. Some clients will generate you a massive profit because you're delivering massive value. Other clients will deliver low profit because you're delivering low value. So you, if you did a kind of a comparison, you'd have, you know, I do that comparison that, you know, you look at your clients like a box of stocks and shares. You know, you're going to have different stocks and shares generating different value multiples depending on their risk and scope, etc. So look at the scope in terms of complexity and preference. Break down what is it that makes a client difficult in terms of their scope, in terms of what's how, you know, the makeup of their business. And this is how GoProposal helps, because it's quite broken down in terms of, you're a bigger company, you're higher turnover, that's going to be more difficult to deal with. The number of transactions, the industry that you're in, the kind of VAT scheme that you're on. You know, all these are complexities, which is how we should differentiate pricing for different clients. And then it comes on to preferences. So what does each client prefer? Some clients want to meet with you every month. Therefore, there should be a higher fee attached to that. Some people are happy with quarterly, some people are happy with annually. So work on the preferences of each client and factor that into your pricing. So really, and that's why I say in the four foundational pillars, start with your pricing, because that's generally the cause of all ills in our accounting firms, because our pricing isn't on point. And then everything else, we do the scope creep and over-servicing, all boils down to our pricing.